Didn't know today would be your last.
Dear Grandma Pat, we think about you all.
Shall we bow our heads and just close our eyes? Gracious God and eternal Father, we invoke your presence in this gathering and throughout this funeral procession as we celebrate the life of our dear sister Patricia Nair. I pray your grace and peace to reign on us as we acknowledge your Holy Spirit to comfort us and to give us strength for today and hope for tomorrow. I pray this in the name of Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Greetings, beloved, in Jesus' name. I want to welcome for those of you who are here this morning and to also all the families who are watching via live streaming and different social media platforms to this funeral procession of our beloved sister Patricia Nair. I know due to COVID-19 restrictions and underlining issues, and geographic limitations, you could not or cannot be able to attend. But I believe, as we realize, we acknowledge your participation and your interaction via social media. I would, to those who are here, to observe all COVID-19 protocols throughout the funeral procession. My name is Pastor Sam Govender, the senior pastor of Solid Truth Worship Center, and this is where our sister Patricia worshipped, served, and connected with her God whom she loved. This is how she worshipped her God. The worship team will now lead us into some of her favorite songs that she loved. And I believe as you worship with us, it doesn't matter where you are geographically, but as we celebrate a life, I would like you to begin to be part of this funeral procession as we salute a saint that has gone to be with the Lord. I'm going to hand over to our worship team, and I want you just to sing and worship God. This is how she worshipped. Maybe you do not understand the way that we worship, but this is how she worshipped. And I believe as we bring her to the place where she worshipped, the altar where she many times came and committed her life. And I believe as we worship God together, won't you connect with us, family, and allow the peace of God to reign in your heart as we celebrate the life of our sister, dear sister Patricia Nair, called to be with the Lord. Over to our worship team.
Hallelujah. Amen. I'm going to invite you to join us as we celebrate the life of a hero, our mother, Sister Patty, in worship. Amen.
Oh Lord, you take me as I am. Lord, you take, oh Lord, you take me, Lord, take me as I am. Oh Lord, you take, oh Lord, you take me, take me as I am, take me as I am. Over and over you call me yours again. You see, no Savior on me, how you love me, how you love me. Your kindness and mercy remind me how you love me, how you love me. Just yes, I am.
Jesus, Lord
Jesus, just as I am. Nothing more, nothing less.
Oh God,
all my regrets and my failure, all of my wrongs have been left at the cross. Now that remains is the Father's love. Oh Lord, you take me as I am. Over and over you call me yours again. You see yourself, you want me, how you love me, how you love me. Kindness and mercy remind me how you love me, how you love me.
You keep breathing. drop on me. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Your love is holding on and it won't let go.
Wonderful songs that mean so much to our sister Pat. Songs that she sang, songs that she danced to, songs that bring such honor to her God. It echoed in her soul. She just stood at the back and we used to watch her worshiping God. And our dear mother loved the Lord so much. She loved the Lord because she knew that He was her only source and that He was the only source of her strength. We have a few tributes from different members of the family. And they could not be here, but we have some visual audio clippings that we would like to share with you. Memoriam in honor of their beloved. I know we are living in difficult times and it's difficult to give a dignified send-off to our loved ones. And some of you will have loved to be here to begin to grace this place and bid farewell. But I believe in your hearts, wherever you are, I want you to understand that the Spirit of God is with you and it will give you the strength and the peace to begin to deal with our grief. We deal with grief in various ways and different ways of dealing with our grief. But I believe the best and the greatest way of dealing with your grief, and that is to ask God to come and take His rightful place. A place in your heart that only He can console, that He can comfort. Our thoughts are with the boys, His sons at this time, who couldn't be with us in quarantine at this time. But our thoughts and our prayers are with them. That wherever they are in that home right now, that God will give them peace and give them the strength that they need to begin to view this live streaming and honor their late mom. We have a few tributes or memoriam. The first one is going to be done by Colin James. That's the brother-in-law of our sister Patricia Nair. And we also have a few other members of family, Jody, Naidu, couldn't be here because of geographic limitations. We also have a niece, Benice, that's also going to be sharing a paying tribute to a great woman, to a great aunt, to a great loved one who's been called to be with God. As we play these video clippings, may you be blessed and may you be just have a wonderful memory of the wonderful life that we have celebrating here today. Can we have that?
Today is going to be a really hard day for all of us, but I am thankful that so many of you are watching this. And although we are separated by distance and we couldn't come together to celebrate the life of such a wonderful person, I know that we share connection through our dear Auntie Pat. My name is Jody, her elder brother Michael's grandson. we are all together in spirit mourning the loss of such a bright light. Your life was a blessing, your memory a treasure. You are loved beyond words and missed beyond measure. I have had the privilege of writing a few tributes for loved ones. This by far has been the hardest and most painful one for me. How do I pay tribute to such a magnificent person? To my gracious Auntie Pat, forgive me if this does not do justice, but I will try my best. Everyone knows Auntie Pat for her chic, trendy, and elegant dressing. So before I begin my tribute, I would like us to remember her that way. It's what she would have wanted. I grew up in front of Auntie Pat, as many of you did, and have fond memories, many of them from all the mischief Ralph and I got up to as children, family gatherings, trips to Durban, Christmas shopping, waiting up on Christmas Eve and New Year's Eve to wish each other. She was all about family. She loved family, she loved her friends, and she loved her church. I think that one special memory that everyone will have and really miss is the smell of her cooking, and that smell just wafting through the house and kitchen entrance, and your mouth would, you know, literally be watering just thinking of it. And not forgetting her delightful Christmas cake, desserts, and butter biscuits. Her generosity knew no limits. She was the kind of person that would share her last loaf of bread with you. She would welcome you into her home, and I mean, she would sleep on the floor just so that you would be comfortable. Anyone who visited Auntie Pat would leave her home feeling blessed. I remember when I was 12, I really wanted these pair of name brand jeans, and it was quite expensive and I couldn't get it, but Auntie Pat made a plan and she made sure that I got those jeans. And that's just the kind of person she was. She remembered everyone's birthdays, anniversaries, and death days. The day that she got a smartphone and WhatsApp, no one was forgotten. I am going to miss those ultra-colorful daily Bible messages and all her status updates. Truth be told, sometimes I would remember special days only because of her. No matter how tough life got for Auntie Pat, or how many people she adored passed away, she remained the most kind, faithful, and loving person. There was never a moment of bitterness. And even people who hurt her, she just forgave them. And she just loved everyone. As many of you know, in the recent year, she lost two brothers in a space of 3 months. Despite those unprecedented times, she went to nurse her brother Morgan till his last breath. And when my grandfather passed on, she made sure she spends a month with my grandmother to help her move in and settle into her new place. And that's who Auntie Pat was. She was selfless, loving, and caring. I and we can only hope to live up to the exemplary life that she led. I always knew the kind of sender Auntie Pat wanted. She would tell us all the time and we would joke about it. I actually chatted to Ralph about it the other day and we were laughing because, we would always tease her about it. And all I know is that these are special circumstances. And this send-off is for a very special person who is loved by many. She always taught me to love everyone whilst they were alive and have no regrets. She said, give those you love flowers whilst they are alive. She truly lived by this as she lived her spirituality. And with Auntie Pat, it was it was never about money or what you bought her, but it was about whether you thought of her or she appreciated those kind of things. Did, like, if you could visit her and buy her the most simplest thing, she would be so happy. Just a call or a message, and she was never materialistic, you know. It was just, she just loved being remembered, and she loved remembering people, and she did it in her own way. You could tell Auntie Pat anything. She was a confidant to me, to many of you, and I know that she has taken a lot of secrets with her. She never judged anyone. I mean, I could tell her anything, and she would just be there to listen to you. She would be there to pray for you. I mean, every set of exams I've written from university, I've always asked her to pray for me. Auntie Pat, I know the flowers I gave you were not enough. I never got to tell you how much I love you before you left. I never got to get you that plane ticket we would always talk about. I will miss our catch-up calls. I am not going to say goodbye. I am going to say take rest. Rejoice with Uncle Patrick and your family in heaven until we meet again. I love you forever.
Dearest Auntie Pat, I have no words to say how much I will miss you. You were the best aunt a child could wish for. Thank you for loving me and Michael Jr. unconditionally, for all the hugs and kisses, messages and presents. Some of our special memories, sleeping with my arms wrapped around your neck until I was 6 years old. My fourth birthday party, still the best party I ever had. You taking me to work with you on the train for my birthday, where I got to sit in a chair next to you and eat a packet of chips. The day you asked me if you should marry Uncle Patrick, and I said no, because I was so jealous, I didn't want to share you with anyone. Tin fish curry, our secret. You are so precious beyond diamonds. God must have wanted you for himself. I know you are an angel, and you will be alive in our hearts forever. Love you lots and lots, like jelly tots. Your niece.
There's one more tribute by Colin James. You just played that as well. The brother-in-law of our sister Patricia, Colin James. Don't have the clip. Beloved, we have one more memoriam from the church. Someone that's been with Sister Patricia when she was in ICU, being a medical doctor and had the privileges of entering the COVID wards, was the only source of connection to someone that she knew. And on behalf of the Church Solid Truth Worship Center, Dr. Clinton Munsami is one of the key leaders in our church. He's our COVID-19 consultant for the church. And he was the last one to be with Sister Patricia. He was the one that was able to just give her a word of comfort in her agony, in her pain, when she was in the casualty ward waiting for a bed. And thereafter, moved to a bed at the ward. He was there. And when she was admitted even into ICU, He was the only person that could get to her and to just give her a word of comfort. And at this time, he has a word, a memoriam to this, just to honor and to just to share with us. These are indeed wonderful, precious memories, wonderful, precious sentiments that we have had with our loved one. I believe as we continue to just give honor, may we do so with dignity, to know that this is a person that has touched our lives in so many ways. She touched my life in so many ways. She touched your life in so many ways. We celebrate a life that was so loving, so full of compassion, a heart of so much of compassion, such a giving person. And indeed, as we hear the wonderful sentiments, our hearts are overwhelmed. Our hearts are broken. Our emotions are shattered. But thanks be to God who's given us hope in the midst of our pain. Over to Dr. Clinton.
It is truly an honor to pay tribute to such an amazing woman, our Auntie Patricia Nair, or we, as we commonly knew her, Auntie Pat. It is an impossible task to try to describe Auntie Pat in just a few words, her valuable contribution to the body of Christ, and especially to this church, Solid Truth Worship Center. Auntie Pat was an essential part of the leadership of this church. She took it upon herself to head up the feeding scheme programs run by the church and to see it fit that all the catering that was undertaken by the church was done well, was well taken care of. And this included feeding of the Sunday school children every Sunday, the pastor's fraternity whenever they met, any visitors and guests that attended our church, as well as organizing of all the functions that the church held. Whatever task Auntie Pat was assigned to, she did it with excellence, with pride, and with joy. She was able to take a simple sandwich and make it into a culinary perfection, a masterpiece. I remember the polony sandwiches that she used to prepare for the Sunday school children. Even the children that hated polony, myself included, loved her sandwiches, and there was never enough. And why, we ask ourselves, it's because it was blessed by Auntie Pat, and it was made with love. Everything she did out of love, for the glory of her God, Jesus Christ. Our God is love, and so was Auntie Pat. If I had just one word to describe Auntie Pat, it would be just that, love. She was loved by everyone, and everyone loved her. She always made sure that everyone in church was well taken care of. The little that she had, she made go a long way. She would often wait in the foyer after church, usually behind the pastors, so that as people greeted the pastors, she would get a chance to greet them as well. She made sure that she spoke to everyone, and the first thing that she asked was, "Are you okay?" And followed by, "Is there anything that I can do for you?" Whenever it was someone's birthday, anniversary, or special occasion, Auntie Pat would go out of her way to prepare something for that occasion, just to make sure that it was extra special. I remember last year on my birthday, Auntie Pat called me in the morning, and she told me, she wished me happy birthday, and then she told me to come over to her house to pick up a special birthday cake. She knew that I had a sweet tooth. And that's how she got to know everyone, through our tummies. And that's how we got to know Auntie Pat, through her cooking. Auntie Pat was an example of how to serve one another humbly in love. She portrayed all the fruits of the Spirit described in Galatians 5:22 and 23, which reads, "But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control." For those of us that knew Auntie Pat, we we knew that she exemplified every single one of those characteristics. Auntie Pat, she has fought the good fight. She has finished her race well. She has kept the faith, and she has been crowned with righteousness today. On this very day, when we come together to say farewell to our beautiful mom, I am reminded of the poem written by David Hawkins, titled, She Is Gone. It reads, you can shed tears that she is gone, or you can smile because she has lived. You can close your eyes and pray that she will come back, or you can open your eyes and see all that she has left. Your heart can be empty because you can't hear, you can't see her, or you can be full of the love that you shared. You can turn your back on tomorrow and live yesterday, or you can be happy for tomorrow because of yesterday. You can remember her and only that she is gone, or you can cherish her memory and let it live on. You can try and close your mind, be empty and turn your back, or you can do what she would want, smile, open your eyes, love, and go on. We will miss you dearly, Auntie Pat. May your soul rest in peace until we see each other on that great and glorious day. On behalf of the Solid Truth Worship Center, I would like to extend my condolences to the family. May God be with you all during this difficult time. Thank you for sharing Auntie Pat with us. She has left a lasting impression on each of our lives. Amen.
Thank you, Dr. Clinton, for those awesome sentiments that we have shared. And thank you for being with Sister Pat at her side on the most difficult part of her life. We couldn't be with her. And God has given you that opportunity and that privilege that you can be with her just to begin to give her a word of comfort. Sister Pat had a friend, Sister Rita Pele, one of her best friends. And it was the family's request that she reads the obituary. I believe she knew Sister Pat for a long time, and she was so close to her. And they were wanting her to read the obituary. She couldn't be here because of COVID-19 restrictions. But we're going to do that via a clipping. She's going to read the obituary in honor of her friend.
Patricia Henry was born on the 8th of December, 1956, to Monsami Henry and Mary Henry. Patricia soon met her beloved husband, late Patrick Emmanuel Nair, and got married on the 13th of February, 1982. This was a perfect reunion, as both Patrick and Patricia were affectionately known as Pat to all. These lovebirds mirrored each other's bubbly personality. Soon thereafter, Patricia became a mother to Clement and Ralph Adrian Nair. Patricia was called away to be with Jesus into his kingdom on the 9th of January, 2021, and be free from pain and illness. Sister Patricia, known as Pat to many, completed her schooling at Southlands High School in Havenside, Chatsworth, and went on to study at the M.L. Sultan Technikon in Durban. She started her work career as an accounts clerk at S.A. Druggist, thereafter moving to Willis Faber, and eventually completed 23 years of service at the Independent newspaper. Brother Patrick served under the leadership of Pastor Sam for many years until his sudden passing away. His loyalty, faithfulness, and support of the ministry are unmatched, and he was often referred to as Pastor Sam's shadow, accompanying him on various ministerial, home, and hospital visits. Patricia immediately stepped into the void left by Brother Patrick and committed herself wholeheartedly to serving in the Solid Truth Ministry, and later would also be regarded as Pastor Sam and Pastor Gloria's shadow. She took sole responsibility for the catering needs of the church, and together with her team, she would prepare meals for approximately 70 children who attended Sunday school. In addition, she would ensure that the pastor's fraternity and all other church events were catered for in a professional and dignified manner, epitomizing a spirit of excellence, which is the cornerstone of the church. Many would remember her as the sister of the late Dr. Michael Hendry and Pastor Morgan Hendry, but her legacy of servitude, worship, and faithfulness was her own. Her jovial nature and infectious laughter made her popular with people of all ages. Her ability to always remember a birthday, share a word of encouragement, pray for others, and remain a faithful and loyal member of the church is what sets her apart from most people. Her pride in her sons, Clement and Ralph, and especially their achievements coming from humble beginnings and achieving great heights, was unparalleled, and she took great joy in supporting and encouraging them in every step of their life's journey. She leaves behind her two sons, Clement and Ralph, extended Nair, James, and Henry families, Solid Truth family, colleagues, and friends.
Father, we honor you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We bless your holy name. Come and let's just worship the Lord. Amen. Father, we honor your holy name. We declare that there is none like you, mighty God. We bless you. We praise you, Jesus.
What I've been waiting for, here is
Oh,
we worship you. Wherever you are right now, you can just bow your heads where you are right now. And allow the Spirit of God and the presence of God to saturate your body, your mind, and soul. I know many of you are grieving right now. Many of you are feeling the sting of death, the pain, and the anguish. And many of you right now in your homes watching this broadcast, watching this procession, I want you to begin to stretch forth your hands to the King of Glory, to the God that our sister Patricia Nair served. This is how she served. This is how she worshipped. This was an expression of her faith. These are the songs that she loved. This is the way that she expressed herself to her God, her Creator and her Maker. As you raise your hands towards the King of Glory, the God that she served, the God that she honored, the God that she loved. As we raise our hands in adoration and declare, Lord, you have given, you have taken. Blessed be the name of our God. And so, Father, I pray for the members of the family right now that, oh God, that have to bid farewell in such a cold manner. But I'm praying, Holy Spirit, that your presence will prevail. And that you grant to each member of the family, especially the sons right now, grace, oh God. For you promised unto us that you will not give us more than we are able to bear. But with the temptation, make a way of escape that we might be able to bear us. So give us strength, Lord. Give us the ability to dig deep, oh God. And so, Father, we want to honor you by listening to your word as you speak to us, O God. May your word bring comfort. May your word bring reassurance. May your word bring hope in a hopeless situation. May your word, O God, bring us to a place that we can deal with our grief and realize that our loss is heaven's gain, O God. So I pray, Almighty God, as we raise our hands and surrender to the God that our dear sister served, we thank you, Father. And give us the strength, we pray thee, to continue to bid farewell. It might be a very cold way of doing it, but help us, Lord, as the church, as members of the family, as his sons, whom she loves so much. Give them strength, Lord, I pray thee. For we ask this in your precious name with much thanksgiving. Amen. Beloved, the best way to describe and to celebrate the life of Patricia Nair, and the best way to celebrate her life, is that to note the life that she lived was a life of significance. And that's the best way to describe a precious saint of God that's been called to higher service. I want you to understand, as we bring a close to a chapter in her life, when I prayed with Clement and Ralph at their home, I had to bring a close of a chapter in her life as a mother in her home. But I believe as we brought her to the altar, and many of my colleagues and many of the members of the church and the family were wide-eyed when I said I want to bring her to the altar under these difficult times. I want you to understand, this is how our dear mother worshipped God. And we bring closure to another chapter in her life as a place where she worshipped. And as we bid farewell and we brought her to this place, to the altar, I want you to realize and understand that she lived a life of significance. Everyone has a desire to do something meaningful with their life. to make a difference and to have a sense of worth and to be someone of significance. And God placed a desire in each one of our hearts. And the good news is that God has created each one of us for a specific purpose. My dear sister Patricia knew her purpose, and she fulfilled her destiny. Man, what a big void and what a big gap she has left in this church. Man, she was a live wire. She took full control of the kitchen. Man, she did so many things. She was a person that had leadership qualities. And not only had the qualities, but she used them to begin to be and add value to the church of God. True joy and fulfillment is found in discovering what purpose we have and pursuing it passionately. Oh, she was passionate in whatever she did. She was passionate in the way that she served. She was passionate in the way that she connected with each one of us. And I want to tell you something. Man, she connected with the children. She connected with the young people. She connected with the older folks. She connected so well because she was a lady of significance. She was a believer of significance. You may have heard of a woman called Dorcas, who was very well known in his city. And we learn about her in the book of Acts chapter 9. We learn about her in the book of Acts chapter 9. And the Bible says that when the apostle Peter in Acts chapter 5 in verses 20, chapter 9 and verses 32, it says, and Peter traveled about the country. He went to visit the Lord's people who lived in Lydia, and he found, and as we go further, he says, yeah, man, he meets this woman, Dorcas. And the Bible says that we find that, man, the people came to there, and we find that when these people came to her, man, and came to him and begin to say, Dorcas, the one that has done so much for us, has been called, has passed on. It's an amazing story of a woman called Dorcas. The Bible says that when the disciples and all the people who knew her came to Peter, and they were showing him all the garments and all the things that Dorcas did. Dorcas was a true believer of Jesus Christ. And here we find that Dorcas, man, came. Man, her life was a life of significance, that the people were in mourning. They were grieved. They were heartbroken like we feel right now. Because of time, I don't have much time to get into the story of Dorcas. But the Bible speaks about Dorcas, who was a woman of great significance. And the people came to Peter, to the disciples, and they showed her what she did. And when in the passing of Sister Pat, man, we had people who came and said, this is what she did. Every Sunday, man, she brought a man something. She placed something in the hands at the in their birthdays. Man, she was such a woman of significance. She was a woman because she loved God. And therefore, she was a woman of significance. True significance comes from having a relationship with God. You can only have a truth, you can only be a person of true significance if you have a relationship with God. And I believe Dorcas had a relationship with their God. She knew about their God, and she knew how to take people, care of the people of God. Sister Pat knew her God. And because of a relationship with their God, she knew how to connect with the body of Christ. Oh, she all knew how to connect with her siblings. She knew how to connect with the people around her because she knew her God and what was expected. People of significance have a relationship with God because the attributes and the character of our God, you begin to emulate the character and the nature of our God. What is our God? Loving? A caring God? A faithful God? A true God? A God that promised us that he will never leave us, neither will he forsake us. A God that is true to her word. And this is what she displayed. She was the exact representation of the kingdom of God because she knew her God. Always willing. Does things with a smile. And we live in a world that seeks significance in various ways. Through prominence, prestige, position, or pleasure. But these things are not necessarily wrong. But they, I believe, that we find that what really matters is that knowing God. And we find that we are living in a time where people are pursuing to be significant for the wrong reasons. But our dear mother, our dear sister, man, she was a lady of significance for the right reasons because she knew her God. She had a relationship with her God. She knew her God. She knew what was expected of her as a believer. Man, that is why so many of our hearts are broken. So many of our hearts are torn apart. My grandchildren were wailing and they were weeping when they heard of our dear sister passing. Oh, I'm saying, man, our children, man, they were so disturbed. Our young people were disturbed. Man, the whole body of Christ came, man, to a standstill where they begin to realize, man, she brought our lives to a standstill, this remarkable woman, because she is a woman of significance. And I believe family and friends, loved ones, are you living a life of significance? Are you living a life, man, that you can say, man, when you pass on, that you can bring the men, lives of people to a standstill, to a halt? Dorcas' life did that. Oh, we find the whole town came to a halt. Man, they were so disturbed, and they brought the things, they spoke of the things that Dorcas did. And I'm saying, we look at our sister Patricia, and man, when you find that, man, the whole family, the whole body of Christ, man, the pastors was even sending us messages because she knew how she served them. They knew how she served them. She served with excellence. And we had to host the pastors many times, the fraternities. As you heard in the tributes. And she was the one that put it together. I can tell her, I can pick up the phone and say, Sister Patricia, the pastors have come to me once again. They said they want to have the meeting tomorrow in this premises. And you know our ladies, when they were having something, man, they want to run around and try to get things in place. But Sister Patricia, man, did it with a smile. Never complained. Never complained. And I'm saying, man, the wonderful dishes that we heard that she prepared for her nieces and her nephews and all those who had a special bond with her spoke about so wonderfully. And I can vouch for every word that they have uttered because this is how she served under this ministry. Oh, she served gracefully because she was a woman of significance. She served wholeheartedly because she had a relationship with their God. She served man without murmur and murmuring. She was truly a Proverbs 31 woman. She had the qualities truly of a Proverbs 31 woman. A woman, man, a virtuous woman. And I'm saying our hearts are torn. We feel a big lump in our throat. We feel the anguish in our hearts. When she told me she was moving away, man, from the place that she was living in for so many years, and she wanted to move a little bit further away, I was troubled. And I said, Sister Pat, why are you moving so far away? She says, no, Pastor Ronnie, I will Uber myself to church. And then she came back and said, no, the boys found a place close by. And we're not so far, Pastor. She'll pick up the phone and say, Pastor, where are you? And I'm always at the church when she phones and says, please stop by. She'll walk down that steps, come to that gate, and she'll hand me a Tupperware with something that I love. Oh, she was such a good cook. Oh, she knew how to take care of the man of God. My heart is torn. I'm disturbed in my spirit that I have to begin to do this final committal to lay to rest and to bid farewell to our dear mother. I want you to know that under this church and the foundation of this verse, of this church, man, she was a mother that brought her request. And I made an appeal to the people who had requests when we were building the church. Whatever request you have, bring it. And we want to put it in the foundations of this church. And I want you to know that God will hear you, because this request that you have placed it in the foundations of this building. And many of those requests and those petitions have been answered. I look at the boys and I see how God took those boys from where they were. Man, how God prospered them and took them through. You hear the story of Ralph and how God took him and how God opened up doors. And how God put him and took him to a place. And how God opened doors for Clement. And how God made a way. And how God brought breakthroughs in their lives. This is the mother. Oh, many times she will come at this altar and bring various requests. She stood at this altar, men, and came before a God. And we came into agreement concerning various things and various petitions and various requests that she brought before the Lord. This is the mother. Oh, that I can vouch. And I can say, yes, she was a lady and a woman of significance, because she knew her God. Oh, true significance comes from having a relationship with God. True significance comes from engaging in good works. That Dorcas, man, we find in the book of Acts chapter 9 and verses 36, man, she says Dorcas was always doing good, helping the poor. And once you start following God, something happens on the inside of you. You become a different person. She engaged in good works. Good works didn't save her. But she engaged in good works, because when you come to God, when you come to know God, you automatically, faith without works is dead. Faith without works is dead. You have a change of heart. You no longer live for yourself. You begin to have a heart for and compassion for others. And this is what she had, a heart for and compassion for others. You begin to follow the steps of Jesus, who went about doing good, found in the book of Acts chapter 10 and verses 38. We're not saved by our good works. We are saved to do some good works for the benefit of others. We are not saved by our good works, but we are saved, man, to do good works for the benefit of others. Unselfish. The Christian life is not a life of just about knowing certain things, but it's about being a certain kind of person. A person of significance. And this is what she was. She was a mother of significance. She was a friend of significance. She was an auntie of significance. She was a member of the church, men that I can truly say that she was a member of significance in the church. Fill in the gap. Whenever there was a shortfall, she was prepared to step in and do if it was within her ability. The world should be a better place because of us. The world was a better place because of my sister Patricia. The world is a better place because of her. Oh yes, she made such an impact in so many of our lives. The Bible says Dorcas made clothes for widows who lived in her city and some of the neediest people in society. They had no one to represent them or to protect them. And they couldn't get much of a job to buy food, let alone other things. But Dorcas stepped in and filled in that gap. This is what our mother did. Stepped in. Every time there was a gap. Stepped in and was able to be a woman of significance. A mother of significance. An auntie of significance. A member of the church of significance. She added value to the body of Christ. She was a blessing to all of us. And that is why we are all, men, feeling so overwhelmed. A person of significance rises above the limitations. We don't know a lot about Dorcas, but she was living in a time where it was a male-dominated society. But she wasn't limited because of her circumstances. And I want to tell you something. Our sister Patman, with all the limitations, man, she had. Man, when he realized our late brother Patrick, he was ill for such a long time. It wasn't easy taking care of him. Pastor knew. Because every time he had a stroke, a part of his brain will die, Dr. Clinton. Every time he had a stroke. And I know it wasn't easy because our late brother Patrick was difficult at times. I know I was his pastor. There were times when she sacrificed, man, her medical aid portions to say, I'd rather send Patrick for treatment rather than me, pastor. This is what she sacrificed. Man, she was a mother, was able to provide for her family over Patrick's illness. It was a long time that he wasn't well. And every time he went into hospital, we prayed him out. Up until the last time. The Lord said it was time to go home. And I heard the call that she made, Pastor, Patrick is gone. Her mother stood in, stepped in. As a widow, she raised and she continued to support her sons. And it's so sad that they just moved to a new place. And how proud of the house that she was moving into. It was just before New Year's that I took her with my, I picked her up and I went and dedicated the house. But so sad she couldn't enjoy that new premises that God blessed them with. Clement and Ralph really stepped in for the last couple of months. And they really wanted to give her mother a better quality of life. She worked hard all her life. And was just about to start to enjoy her retirement. And enjoy what her sons could offer her. The Lord saw it fit to take her and call her to a place that he has prepared for her. Oh, she spoke so much of what she was going to do, but she never got to enjoy the new premises that they moved into, the bigger kitchen that she was going to, that she loved to do, and the things that she loved to do was to cook and to bake. Never got to enjoy it. We salute their mother. Of great significance, who rose above the limitations in her family circumstances. Oh, yes. She was able to also value faithfulness. Doctors did not just help one person one time. She made it a lifestyle. She valued faithfulness. And I'm saying, man, she was a mother of significance because she valued faithfulness. She was consistent. Never did it once and then sporadically did it for you. It was continuous, Dr. Clinton. Always giving out. I've watched her. I've watched her, man. Man, even families that was going through a difficult time, she would cook and send for them. She would pick up the phone and say, Pastor, you need to send a hamper. You need to have some, man, supply some sort of aid to some people. Oh, she would come and she would say, Pastor, yes, we need to be doing this thing. She was the first one every time Pastor Thomas, man, Lillian was sick. She would be the first one every time we said we're going to visit Pastor Thomas. Man, my co-pastor, man, who couldn't be part of this program because not treating too well. But yeah, we find every time my wife would pick up the phone and say, we're going to visit Pastor Thomas. She'll tell my wife, what can I prepare? This is a mother. Mother of significance. Mother that made such a value, man, a valuable impact in our lives. A woman of significance. A person of significance leaves a legacy. When Dorcas died, she left a legacy. A legacy that so many people came and showed Peter. My sister Pat was called. It came so suddenly. It came as a shock to us. We know it is appointed unto man once to die. But we didn't expect. When I phoned her that morning, and I heard her voice, because I was communicating with the boys when she was sick, but I wanted to speak to her, and I heard her voice, and she told me, "Pastor, I'm not feeling well. I'm really sick, Pastor." The alarm bells went off in my heart, and I knew she was in trouble. And I ran that whole morning trying to get an oximeter that I was advised to get for them, just to be able to measure her oxygen levels. My heart was overwhelmed. She went so quick. But James speaks about life is like a vapor. Life is like grass. But I believe, child of God, how do you live your life? Do you live a life of significance? For those members of the family that are watching us, is your life lived? Is your life a life of significance? May we be challenged by the death of our dear mother, our dear sister Patricia Nair, who lived a life of significance. Oh, she has left a big gap in this church. And we're praying God will begin to. When late Brother Patrick was called to be the Lord, Brother Patrick left a big gap. She stepped in. It was almost like a relay. Patrick passed the baton to her. And she stepped in. And I want to say to Ralph and Clement, I believe Mother is passing the baton to you. Her assignment has been finished. She has completed her assignment. She has run the race well. She has completed her assignment. But I believe she's passing the baton to her children. And I believe that you will take upon yourself to pick up the baton and to run the race that is set before you and to be an individual of significance. How do you live your life? Do you live a life of significance? It's about choosing to serve each day. She was small in stature, but huge in impact. Small in stature, but huge in impact. What impact are you making in the lives of the people around you? May you be challenged. May you be motivated. May you be encouraged as we salute us a life of significance. Rise above your limitations. Engage in good works wherever you are. Value faithfulness. Be a servant for the long haul. Endeavor to leave a legacy. Don't just live your life. Make a difference. That is my word to you that are living. To the members of the family, to the body of Christ of solid truth, to everyone who knew her, then endeavor. Just don't live your life. Endeavor to leave a legacy. Then don't just live your life, but make a difference in your sphere of influence. I want you to bow your heads wherever you are at this time. As we proceed to the cemetery, West Park's, I beg your pardon, the Confluy. Cromfay Cemetery, as we make our way there, I will instruct you, for those who are following us, to put your headlights on as we go to the Cromfay Cemetery to lay to rest a woman of significance. This is just the earth suit that she occupied. But at the point of her departure, when their soul and spirit left this body, the Bible says to be absent from this body is to be present with God. I want you to just raise your hands wherever you are once again. As I pray a blessing over the family, that the peace of God will reign. As we proceed to the Cromfay Cemetery, that God will give us strength and God will give us the ability to begin to bid farewell to a lady, to a woman of significance, to a mother of significance, to an auntie of significance, to a loved one, a friend, a colleague who has impacted our lives. Gracious Father, I pray that you'll give us strength, O God. I pray that you'll enable us by the power of the Holy Spirit. I pray for the members of the family, the sons especially, and all the members of the family of our sister Patricia. I'm praying that you'll touch every one of their lives and that you might be able to stir in their hearts that this lifestyle that she had, that she lived, this lifestyle that she adopted is because of the God that she served. I pray, Lord, that you'll give us and give each one of the members of the family strength, O God, to begin to know that this great woman of God has been a woman of significance in our lives that can motivate us to be able to be an individual that will be able to be significant in our passions, in our lifestyles, that we might be able to honor our God. So bless us, we pray thee, Lord, as we leave this place, a place that she worshipped, a place that she honored her God, a place that was a gateway to heaven, Lord, a place that she came to realize that the only way is Jesus. And so, Father, we thank you and we bless you for your word. For your word is so powerful, O God. For your word is able to comfort us. Your word is able to give us strength, O God. Your word is able to bring us and give us hope so that we can pursue a lifestyle of significance. I pray your blessings over us, Lord. May your blessings rest upon us. May your peace reign in our hearts, Lord. May your grace continue to be with us as we proceed, O God, to lay to rest the remains of this body. I pray this in the name of Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious upon you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace as we continue to celebrate the life of our dear sister Patricia Nair. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Shall you stand to your feet wherever you are as we lead this coffin out of this place of worship, a place that she worshipped and she honored her God.
Good day to you all. My name is Colin James, and I'm speaking on behalf of the Nair family, the Joseph family, and the James family. There's so much for us to say about Patricia, but time is limited, so I'll get straight to the point. The most memorable recent occasion that we had to celebrate was Christmas, and Patricia was every part of that. All of us got together, we shared some laughter and jokes, and Patricia was so happy in moving into a new home, and she bragged about having a chef's kitchen and she was going to be preparing us the best meals ever. We know Patricia for many, many years, and a faith and devotion to the church, the congregation, and her participation has been second to none. We know that, and we will treasure that. Patricia has left an indelible mark in our hearts and minds, which we will always treasure. Wherever she is, up there with the Lord, we know that she's not alone, and we know that she's not suffering at all. And we remember her for her courage and determination in inspiring Clement and Ralph whenever they were in a crisis. She also did that for us. She always had a kind word to say and words of encouragement to us whenever we needed that. Patricia, we have to tell you that you will be very much missed by the family, by the friends, and by all that knew you, from Chatsworth to Stanger to Johannesburg to Randburg. You will greatly be missed. We love you lots. Thank you.
Grandma Pat, we think about you always. We talk about you still. You have never been forgotten and never will. We hold you close within our hearts, and there you will remain. Thank you, Grandma Pat, for your love and care. Thank you for always spoiling us with your delicious food and baking. We will forever remember your beautiful smile and laughter. Good night, Grandma Pat. Sweet dreams. We love you always. From your babies, Mika, Zamian, Zach, and Bella.